Yesterday, I had all access to photograph the Ben Folds concert at the Fillmore in Philly. So in this vlog, I want to tell you how I got all access to photograph Ben Folds while giving you tips on how you can get in to shoot musicians and bands or get access to whatever you would like to get access to, and then break down how I photographed the show and talk about some of the images that I captured. Now, I get messages all the time asking, how do I get access to a concert? How do I get passes to go to a concert? And it's really simple. There's two things that you need when you're getting started. You need an affiliation and you need work. You need to be able to prove that you're worthy of going in and getting a pass for this event because you have work to show. The other thing you need is an affiliation. Is it a newspaper? Is it a school newspaper? Is it a magazine? Is it a blog? What is it? And if you don't have an affiliation right now, guess what you can do? You can make your own music blog or vlog. Start reviewing music on Spotify. Start reviewing new albums. Because people always go, well, if I have nothing to show them, how am I going to get access? And if I can't get access, how can I show somebody something? You need to figure it out. That's the hard truth, is you need to figure out what you need to do to make it happen, and somebody's not going to make it happen for you. Review albums on Spotify. Work with new local bands to get access to the local bands that are small. Call them up and say, hey, I'd like to photograph your show. Now, you may not make money at it up front, but it will lead somewhere over time, and that's how you start to get to the bigger acts. Now, how did I get to Ben Folds? Is a couple years ago, he was in here at my loft where we did a Raw Talk interview about photography. He is a photographer. I think I got a random email from his record company, and they were looking to do interviews in the city when he came through, and I said, well, I'd like to talk to him about photography, not so much about music. And we made it happen. And yes, it doesn't hurt that I have a big following, and the following is something that I can show, but again, I started with zero at day one, same place where a lot of you are, and I got the access, I got the yes. Not only did we get to have the interview, but I also got to photograph that show. So fast forward to yesterday, and he was back through town. I contacted the label, the tour manager, everybody I needed to contact to say, hey, I'd like to come down and photograph again down at the Fillmore, which is 3 blocks from my house, which is awesome to have a venue that's that good right down the street. And he gave me all access to shoot what I wanted. I got to shoot the VIP masterclass that he started with, where he sits there and he talks and answers people's questions, and then he does a little masterclass type set for more people that come in, so it's he and his piano. And I was looking for a really good place to shoot, because what's going through my mind when I'm photographing a solo artist that's on the piano is that the best shot is probably from behind the artist, facing out to the crowd to get all of the people in there and the piano, and that's gonna be the best wide angle massive shot. Not so much a tight shot of a guy playing a piano. There's not too many great shots that will come out of, you know, a piano player that's live on stage, because you don't have control of quite a bit. So what happened is I found this great spot behind the curtain where I had to lay on the ground, because all that's on the stage is a piano, a monitor, and basically it's wide open and just Ben is gonna be playing. So I saw that I could lay down on the ground, lift up the bottom of the curtain, put my lens through, look through my camera, and have a perfectly centered picture or a place to get a great photo. So I got some nice stuff during soundcheck, but I also went on stage during soundcheck because I wasn't gonna be that much of a distraction. Now during the show, I wanted to do the same thing. And then I realized he had a water bottle that was boning my shot. It was right there where I needed to get the photo. It just became a distraction. I still took the images. I still got some cool, tighter shots. So there were 3 different images I was trying to focus on getting. Now, one of them was that wide angle shot from behind, because that's really important to show that wide angle and to show the venue. Those are impactful images. The next shot was at the end of the first intermission, the first set that he did, he was gonna get up and he was gonna play drums and do a drum solo. Well, I knew I wanted to get shots of that as well. And finally, it was the paper airplane request tour, where people would write down the song they wanna hear on a piece of paper, fold it into a paper airplane, and throw it on the stage. So I knew I wanted to get that shot at the end of the night. Now what happened is, they started throwing the airplanes before Ben came out. Now I didn't want to stay on the ground hidden. I went out on stage, behind the piano, as people were throwing their paper airplanes. And then Ben came out and stood in right at the piano, giving me this wide shot. Now, there weren't as many paper airplanes being thrown at the time he was standing there, but I had enough of them in the image to make it look great, as well as all of the airplanes that were already on the stage. So that was the shot. That was the main shot that I wanted to get. So backstage, we didn't have a lot of time to shoot because he was busy calling his family, stretching, doing what he needed to do. And so I didn't really get any candid shots in his dressing room, but that's all right. I got the shots that I wanted to get, and I'm really happy with the results that I got there. Now, I didn't get a ton of keepers, but the ones that I got tell the story that I was hoping to tell when I went in there with the right mindset to capture what I wanted to capture. And that's what it's all about. So again, thank you to the Ben Folds team for allowing me to come in there and do that. Thank you to you, Ben, for allowing me to have access to capture these images. And by the way, the last time around, I got this awesome photo that ended up being his tour poster where he gave me the finger on stage, which was... it's a really cool photo. I love how that one came about, and I have a video about that as well, breaking down how that image happened. So I hope this kicks you in the ass. If you're somebody who's contacted me saying, I don't know how to get access and I've tried everything, well, you haven't tried everything, and you need to figure it out. You need to figure out how to get access on your own. I've given you the tools that you need and the insight that you need to get started, but you need to take it the next step. I can't get you access to a show, and I'm not just gonna give out people's information. Everything is readily available online. You have to figure out how to make it happen, have that affiliation, have work to back it up. And if you bitch and moan and complain and say, well, you don't know where to start, how do you get access if you don't have work? You need to figure it out. And that's where I'll leave it. So to check out some of the past vlogs, go ahead and click up on the screen right now to go ahead and check those out. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share this. If you want to give it a share, I would greatly appreciate it. And that's it. Until the next vlog, bye.